So let's talk now about Hadoop, the next generation of Hadoop One. In Hadoop One, we had two components, MapReduce and HDFS. And on top of these two components, we had built a lot of software that was data intense and wants to process data. In Hadoop 2, the goal was to enable real-time and interactive processing of events. Therefore, they introduced a new component, which is YARN. So we still have HDFS, so our storage component, but we now have a cluster resource manager, which provisions the compute resources. Okay, and works in concert with the storage. And on top of YARN, we have execution engine that is able to process any kind of data flow processing. And MapReduce is one part of data flow processing that can still be run. But also we can run additional software. Also, a component, a software can directly interact with YARN to request certain compute resources. So also Hadoop 2 supports NFS, which means you can mount Hadoop at DFS directly on your system and it looks like a hierarchical file system. There are additional features which I don't talk about much, but the key idea is that TES processes now directed acyclic graphs of jobs. We'll talk about this in a minute. So with YARN, we now modularized this job tracker functionality. You remember we had only one component, which was this job tracker, that was scheduling all these compute resources before. This is, can be a bottleneck. Now we have YARN. YARN has only the purpose to manage the compute resources and to monitor arbitrary jobs. So what are now those compute jobs? Well, we run applications in containers. And when we submit a container, we have now a new resource manager component, which is a global daemon that assigns these compute resources to applications. And it schedules the resources among the applications and makes sure that the provisioning is done properly. So it works in concert with an application master. So the application master, now every application that requests resources has one application master process that talks to this resource manager component. And that then negotiates the container resources and interfaces with the execution and monitoring of tasks to the resource manager. Okay, so we, instead of having one global job scheduler, we have now one global resource manager, but this one is much thinner in its capabilities because we have this application masters. We also have something that's called node managers, which manages and monitors local resources. Now the figure looks like this. Clients submit their jobs to the resource manager, the global manager, on the node managers on each node permanently running communicate the information about the status and the progress and so on to the resource manager. And then we have this application one, the blue one, has one application master and the client has one application master, and the containers which run the application communicate with this application master, which communicates with the resource manager. So that's much more scalable, because it now the resource manager can handle up to n many application masters and therewith n many independent applications, instead of monitoring all the nodes and all the progress of all containers by itself.